All right, everybody. Can you guess where I am? And look what I've got. Those are both of John's canvas tents. Got my rucksack all packed up, minus my hammock and my tarp. Just waiting for John. I've just left him after getting these tents off him, and I'm waiting for him coming along that path. Yeah, it's gonna be good. Going out for two nights this time. Loving it. Anyway, I'll catch up with you in a bit. I'm gonna unpack my bike, chain it up to a tree. There we go. That canvas tent strapped in my bag, no bother. My helmet in there as well. There's that tent for John. I really need to wash my bike. Although there's not much point, I only washed this about 3-4 days ago and it's just as filthy as it was before. Anyway, I'm just going to stand here, warm up. I'm a bit cold after driving without any of my motorbike gear on. I've just got my walking trousers and my Gore-Tex on. Stand here and wait for John. See you in a bit. Here he is. Aye, we're a wee bit down the road now. Sorry for all the shaking, there's not much I can do about it. And there we are, pretty much set up now. There's my tent for the time being, and there's John's one. Pretty cool. Got my stove set up for a brew. John's just unpacking. We're here on this beach. It's a little stone beach right next to the river. Awesome. The birch bark, one of those wax lints. Birch bark is just the best fire lighter.
Ah, is it? It's free too.
Yeah. Yeah, put some of this on.
I love beach fires.
Yep.
Grand.
Champion. Fire's fairly going now, compared to when we were starting it.
Beach fire this life.
Yeah. Awesome. The joys of driftwood.
Oh, I love driftwood.
Yeah. And yeah, we put a semicircle stone wall around it. Kind of easy to do when there's this amount of stones. But that's really making a difference, stopping the smoke from blowing straight into our faces. John went away to get some wood and came back with two nicely sawn logs to sit on, even though he doesn't have his chainsaw.
It's amazing what you find down the river, right?
And a massive one to use as a table.
It's just like, isn't it, look?
It's like,
we always find good
John's
stuff.
Like, look what I found.
We always find good stuff down the river, it's awesome.
Yeah. Look what the river washed up.
There's one of them, and it's like a tree, and it's literally, it must be 25 feet long, that thick, and it's just ready for my chainsaw. Like,
that'll be good for another timer. Yeah, it's a nice change having a tent up. It's cool. It's been a while since I've done any ground dwelling. I'm glad I've got my mat, or it would have been a totally different story on one of those bloody foam mats.
You'd have been sleeping on the cobbles.
Yeah. And yeah, there's our tent, there's the fire, and if I take 5 steps this way, there's the river. It's kind of weird when you don't have your head torch on and you're sitting there and you can hear the river, because it sounds like it's right next to you. Just in here boiling the bag meals on my new stove. Working real nice. Really good night, enjoying it, chilling by this really, really warm fire. It's too warm to cook these on, the tops of the packets were just melting, so yeah, got the stove on the go. There you go, ration meals, nice. Well, this is an odd one in a tent, but I'm really comfortable and I'm really, really warm. So I've got that about 4 feet away from me. There's some fire. Anyway, I'm gonna go to sleep now. It's been chilling here for a while. See you in the morning. Morning, everybody. And what a cold morning it is as well. I woke up at about 5:30 this morning. And yeah, might as well have been sleeping in an icebox. This is the inside of the canvas tent. I'm not doing it as much now, but nice bit of come on, focus. No, it's melted already. Basically, there's ice on the inside of my tarp, my tent, frost,
You can see the outside of John's. How frosty that is.
Morning.
So, just waiting for the stove to boil up some water for a coffee and oh, sit here and warm up. Thankfully John got the fire going before I'd even surfaced. So I'm just gonna sit here and enjoy that for a bit and get up and have a good day of filming. Yeah, coffees are made. Really enjoying my little stove. Great bit of kit. Really good for 12 quid.
Found the best place to sit.
John's got a good place to sit.
Had to be in the fire pit.
Yeah. I don't blame you, I'm gonna join you soon, like.
Dude, it's nice and warm here.
Pretty necessary. And you can see like everything's white. There's even like frost on those logs over there. It's a chilly morning. I'm finally getting nicely warmed up, sitting next to the fire. It's a grand morning. Starting to clear off. It was a bit sort of foggy and misty earlier on.
Everything's white over there, like behind us.
Aye, it is.
It's frosty. Even my tent's still frosty.
Mine's pretty frosty on the other side as well. Aye, it's been a cold one.
For breakfast we're going to have sausage rolls. So I've got some sticks sharpened off to put our sausage on, and then we'll just angle them over the fire so they can cook. We'll just keep on turning the stick, get two of them. We'll try and put six on each.
Bit of a sausage stabber there, John.
You didn't sharpen that end.
Sausage fork. There we have it. Gonna be a nice breakfast. Sausages are cooking nicely now. Some nice colour to them. Looking forward to eating them. It's been packing up slowly. Got my sleeping bag and everything packed away. Just need to take the tent down. But I'm gonna do that once I've eaten. Oh yeah. So got another water on for coffee.
Coffee. Yeah.
The lifeblood of camp is coffee, like. Well, we're on the way to the second location for the second night. Nice to get out into some of the sun. It's a really nice day up here, just a few feet further up the bank. Yeah, Yeah, we're set up pretty much just about 100 yards up the beach.
Different beach though.
Yeah, different beach. Smaller beach. And that's about all of it there is. Just got the fire going, using some birch bark and some of these wood shavings from John's fire kit. Got it set up on this big log just to keep it up off the wet ground and get a bit better air circulation in through it. Just like last time, it'll not take long until it's a massive raging fire. Already collecting shed loads of wood. Job's a good one. God, wood.
Got lots of wood.
Aye, it's going grand. Not be long before it's rearing up. Now, John just gave me a snack from a coffee. Some Pop Tarts, some Kit Kats, Whisper. They're nice with the coffee, those are. Snack. All good. Fire's massive now. John's built a cool little wind deflector, and it's basically just drying firewood for later on, but it's serving a purpose for the time being. Right, starting some nice heat.
You heard that, people. That was Tim that suggested we burn our fire deflector, not me.
Oh man.
Shoulders are killing
us. Yeah. Fire's big now. I'm sitting right here, right next to it, and I'm cooking. I'm cooking, John, I'm cooking. Even like back here in the tent. Oh, I stretch my legs out, and yeah, they're right next to the fire. Which is not too bad, it's kind of comfortable. Oh, having a really nice, chilled day. I went for like another 10 minute wood hunt and got this big old stack of wood. Fire's grand. Some big old bits of wood on there as well. Awesome. It's time to get a bit dull now. Sun's going down behind the brow of the hill and it's clouding over a bit. And you see the smoke from our fire coming up from behind the bushes. Yeah, we've had to move away from the fire is the only option. Either that or lose your eyebrows. But yeah, coffee, sitting enjoying a coffee and some pop tarts. And a really good chilled evening. John's got some dinner on, some ribs and chicken leg. Really nice. Ribs are done.
Oh, they just fall off the board.
Yeah, really nice. Garlic bread. Looks nice.
That's the chicken. Chicken thighs.
And we're gonna have to start our fire because it's looking pretty poor.
And for dessert, triple chocolate trifle and white chocolate cookies. Pretty extreme. Fire's roaring. Oh, very warm. I've retreated to my tent for the time being. I'm in absolutely roasting by that fire. So nice. Can feel the heat coming in the tent and just coming in the door. So I just taken a bit of a break from sitting on the rocks, having another coffee and just relaxing. I've been in a chocolate trifle coma for like the last hour. Just been sitting here like falling asleep next to the fire. And it's only about 7:45 or something. Oh man. Great night. Looking forward to a sleep in this tent again. Hopefully, being in a slightly different location, it will not be as rocky and things. The stones are a lot smaller than they were in the last place, so it's not as pointy. And hopefully it won't be as cold as it was last night. That fire is huge. Those flames are licking up higher than these tents that we're in. It's really hot. Sitting right back here in the tent. No, don't even need my coat. Well, that's me for the night. I'm absolutely knackered. Just lying here for the past wee bit, just enjoying the view to the fire and the mass amounts of heat that's barreling in. Really nice. Anyway, I'll catch you in the morning. Morning. I had a terrible night's sleep again. It's two nights in a row of sleeping for maybe an hour at a time. And waking up with agony in my shoulders. Moments like these, I remember why I bought a really expensive hammock. Oh, that's me all packed away now. And John, just standing having a chat, and then we're going. And then pack up the bike and away home. But yeah, that's going to be the last clip. Thanks for watching. Hope you all enjoyed. See you again.